I'm Rob Whitfield with the Orange County Register, and welcome to OCN2 for Tuesday, December 16th. Yesterday's rainstorm prompted mandatory evacuations in the fire-scorched hillsides of Yorba Linda, with mud threatening to overflow barriers placed between the hillside and homes on San Antonio Road. No major damage was reported, and evacuated residents were allowed to return home yesterday afternoon. But with a 40% chance of more rain by early Wednesday, the need for any further evacuation orders will be evaluated this morning. Meanwhile, a rock and mud debris flow in Modjeska Canyon temporarily closed the entrance to the canyon off Santiago Canyon Road, leaving at least one resident to survey a 2-foot-thick pile of rock, mud, and debris right outside their home. And in Anaheim, the roof of the Orange County Regional Occupation Program building on Ball Road collapsed, sending 14 people ages 17 to 50 to the hospital with injuries. None of the injuries were life-threatening, and most were released later in the afternoon. A 68-year-old Lake Forest woman was killed by a freight train after the car she was in became stuck on the railroad tracks near Lakeview and Orangethorpe Avenues last night. Authorities say a passerby tried to save the woman from the oncoming train, but it was too late. Police dispatchers received a panic call from someone about a vehicle stuck on the tracks about 5:50 p.m. A man could be heard in the background yelling, "Get out!" and then the phone went dead. Its whistle blaring, a freight train heading west slammed into the four-door car and pushed it about 15 feet with the woman still inside. The woman, later identified as Linda Kruger Small of Lake Forest, was taken to a nearby Kaiser Foundation hospital where she was pronounced dead. In Anaheim, a woman was burned beyond recognition when the car she was in exploded in the parking lot of an apartment complex on South Dale Street. A gasoline container was found in the vehicle, but authorities said they do not know what ignited the container, which caused the explosion, nor whether the woman was killed in the explosion or was burned in the explosion after she was already dead. 10 apartments were temporarily evacuated while authorities conducted their investigation, which continues. And yesterday, the Monday of the last full week before Christmas, is traditionally the busiest mailing day of the holiday season, but the rain may have kept it from being the busiest in Orange County. Still, post office officials said post offices across the county were busy as people rushed to get cards and packages to their destinations before Christmas. The U.S. Postal Service expects to deliver 19 billion packages between Thanksgiving and Christmas. And you can read more about all of these stories and get your breaking news all day at OCRegister.com.